I'm making this video so that you can all learn from my past mistakes and not be a grade A fool like I was. That's it. That's my intro. Hey, I'm Amanda and you're watching Swell Entertainment. I know I'm fully clothed, and I'm going to stay that way. Technically, my thumbnail isn't gonna be clickbait because I will be showing the photos of me in the bathing suits, so you'll be seeing them, but I'm gonna stay fully clothed throughout this video. I'm sure you will all let me know in the comment section whether or not that's still clickbait. About this time last year, I was approached to be a brand ambassador for a swimsuit company. I should have told them to off. I'm just kidding. And nothing that dramatic happened, but I decided that it would be a good time for me to talk about this because MLMs are like a huge topic on YouTube right now and how predatory they can be. And I feel like ambassadorships are another predatory way of getting sales. So I thought it would be a good time for me to talk about my experience being scouted for an ambassadorship. I'm not gonna call this company out by name because I don't want to be sued, but this company is still very active on social media. They are still an active company and I know they are still reaching out to young women to have them be brand ambassadors. And I'm fairly certain, because I still get the emails, that the means that they use to entice ambassadors to join and spend money with them are still in place. So hopefully by making this video, if you are approached for an ambassadorship, you can know the signs to look out for to see if you're being taken advantage of. Hopefully me losing money helps you save money. I will be showing photos of me in bikinis. The two sets of photos were taken at different times. During one of the shoots, I guess, I was quite sick. I was still dealing with my bronchitis that I had last year, which is probably one of the reasons I stayed sick for so long. My point though is that I look better in some photos than I do in others. So I am going to still show you all of these photos, but we'll see where my self-esteem is at the end of this. I'm not feeling optimistic. So last July, my friend and I went to Victoria Beach in Laguna because I saw photos of the pirate castle and the Thai pool thing on Pinterest, and I wanted to take photos like a basic bitch. Here are some of the photos we took. My friend did a good job. I thought I looked cute. I posted way too many of these pictures. Now what happens with my Instagram, because I'm bad at engagement, is that I post a photo and I plan to wait a day or two to post another one, but what ends up happening is I don't like my feed looking lopsided, so I just dump all three photos at different points in the same day. Super annoying. Then I did wait a couple of days, posted a couple more pictures, and then waited a month, posted some other promotional stuff for my YouTube channel, and then posted more photos from that beach trip. Because content. When I started posting the second round of photos in August, a swimsuit company's talent scout account started commenting on the photos saying they wanted me to DM them because they wanted me to be an ambassador from their brand. I think I posted six photos in August from that shoot and they commented on three of those six photos. This brand reaching out to me at all should have been my first red flag. This was on my Instagram, this wasn't on my YouTube channel. On Instagram at the time, I had maybe 520 followers. I think you become a micro-influencer like upwards of 10,000, and then like 10,000 to 100K is a micro-influencer, and then up then goes to influencer, I believe. So just them reaching out to me at all because of my Instagram alone should have been one of the red flags, because they weren't asking me to like model for them, nor would they, because yeah. I really like these photos. I do like how I look in these photos. My friend Kat did a great job, but they're not like, holy shit, we need to give this girl free shit. You know? So if a brand starts commenting on your stuff, look at your follower account and think, does this make sense? If them reaching out to you doesn't make a lot of sense, maybe don't pursue it at all. I did. Before reaching out to them, I did go and look at their Instagram account and they had quite a large following, which, looking at it now, a good deal of this number was probably a bunch of bots. They had a lot of different body types on their Instagram, and so that was like, okay, this kind of makes more sense to me. That kind of added a little bit of justification to why they were reaching out to me. Almost every photo they had on their Instagram was of one of their ambassadors. All of their ambassadors were tagged in the photos. All of them had a kind of a variety of followers, but they had a good size numbering of followers. From looking at the Instagram and looking at the posts of the different ambassadors that they had, I was able to justify it in that mind, like, oh my god, being on this site like helped their Instagram. At the time, that was something I really wanted to do, was grow my Instagram. Now I'm like, I kind of want to grow my Instagram, but I give less of a But at the time, it was something that I really wanted to do. So I DM'd the official company account, hey, your talent scout told me to reach out to you, and they responded with what was clearly a copy and paste message talking about what I would get from being a part of their ambassadorship. The first thing they mentioned is that they love my feed and thought I'd be a perfect fit. I really didn't post bikini photos prior to this group set of photos because I just wasn't super confident with how I looked. They then talked about how I would be receiving 50% off my first order with them and then a 40% off discount for the rest of my time time as an ambassador, they would also give me a discount code for my followers. And then if my followers use that discount code, I would get store credit. I would also get opportunities to travel overseas and the opportunity to enter into monthly giveaways. All they asked was that I would tag the company in the photos and then also use the hashtag for their company. They asked if I'd be interested. I said yes. I asked a question about if the 50% off was off one item or the whole purchase. I like that my only real question for them was about the 50% off discount code. Not why am I spending money to be a part of an ambassadorship. Not how many girls do you reach out to. Not how many ambassadors do you currently have. Not what exactly are these opportunities for traveling and the giveaways. Not why is it store credit? Why aren't you paying me for my followers spending money with you guys? No valid questions, nothing of real depth. They then said it was 50% off the whole purchase and that was apparently good enough for me. They immediately sent me over the application form for becoming an ambassador. Basically, if you have to apply for an ambassadorship, if they send you a form or if you see an ad like, hey, apply to be an ambassador, be wary, or better yet, don't do it. Keep scrolling. Most of the times they are offering just a discount for your stuff and then the chance to be featured. But again, that is a chance. There's no guarantee you're gonna be featured, so there's a chance you're still gonna be spending too much money on certain products in an effort to be featured, and then it's kind of a waste of time or money, especially if you're not really sure you like this product. Maybe you do like the brand and they're offering an ambassadorship opportunity and you apply for it and you get it and you get clothes out of it that you like. Great, go for it, but have healthy expectations. The term ambassador program isn't necessarily a negative thing. There's plenty of other brands that do ambassador programs where they don't make you pay for things. However, a lot of them do, specifically the ones that target young content creators with smaller followings who clearly want to grow their followings. I tagged my swimsuit photos up the ass. Basically, I made it very clear that I wanted to grow my following. It was a fairly basic run-of-the-mill application. I put in my handle, I put in my name, I put in my email address, and then I got an email saying I was an official brand ambassador. Heck yeah. All I had to do was follow them on Instagram, turn on post notifications, tag them in my bio, put my discount code for my followers in the bio, but I also got bonus points if I linked the website in my bio. They sent me the 50% off code, the 40% lifetime code, and then also again the code for my subscribers, which at the time was loveyou2golka25 because it was based off my Instagram handle. Let me make something clear. I knew as I was applying for it, I was like, this is a good way for them to get sales, asking a bunch of girls to be ambassadors. I knew that, but I thought I could make it work for me. So I, being the genius that I am, ignored that logical thought of reason and started looking at the swimsuits on the site. And a lot of them were fairly cute. They didn't look super cheap. All the photos seemed to be like official photos that they had taken. At the time, they were also doing a buy three, get one free swimsuits for new ambassadors. It's my understanding that this is an ongoing promotion. Limited time offer ending soon, my ass. Now, I think also what ended up getting me here is that this was not a US-based company. This was an Australian-based company. All of the prices for the swimsuits were in Australian dollars. The conversion rate for the US dollar to the Australian dollar was pretty good at the time, so I think past Amanda was like, really, I'm saving money. So yeah, I'm spending over $100, but I'm saving a lot. So I ended up paying for 4 swimsuits. One size switch up. Typically, swimsuits aren't sold in sets that often anymore. They're sold like top and bottoms, which is stupid, but it's good for a lot of people. For instance, in my case, I have no boobs, but I definitely cannot fit into a size small bikini bottoms. It's not happening. And then also in the notes for the order, I put which bikini I wanted for free. So that's not included in what I paid. Now, I'm gonna read off the prices for these bathing suits. And once again, this is the official prices for the bathing suits, not counting my discount code, and then my total, which does have the discount code applied to it. And that's all in Australian dollars. This is not US dollars. I was banking with a different bank at the time, so I don't off the top of my head know exactly what I ended up paying, but I'm sure you can figure it out. $89, $99, $99, $89. And then with the discount, it took off half of it. So I ended up paying $192.95 in Australian dollars. It warned me that because it was coming from Australia, it would take a bit. It ended up taking 14 days. Not because it came from Australia, because I checked the tracking all the time. No, my swimsuits were never in Australia. They came from China. Are you realizing what's happening now? Yeah, it's drop shipping, which to my knowledge isn't illegal. But it's not something you want to be caught really involved with, especially on YouTube right now. I know not that long ago, a couple different YouTubers got called out for doing brand deals with dropshipping sites. That's something that now I definitely wouldn't do. Not that I would have done it then, but at the time I didn't know what this was. So it took about 14 days to get to me. And when I did get it, it came in the standard AliExpress packaging. I've bought stuff from AliExpress in the past. I know how AliExpress packaging works. It's fairly standard regardless of who you buy from on AliExpress. Now, I got rid of most of the bathing suits that I got, mainly because they were all cheap as and also looked really fucking stupid on me. I only got photos in three of them because the day that I went to go do the swimsuit photos just didn't work out too well. Again, I was sick. It was also way too crowded at the beach for me to be changing underneath a towel on top of a rock. So here's one. It's quite cheap. I'm not sure if you can see on camera how thin the fabric is. Typically with bathing suits, that's the last thing you want is to be able to see the lining pop through. In some of the photos, you can see the lining. I tore the bottoms of those ones backwards, otherwise my whole vagina is out. Here's another one. This one I actually kind of like the color, but again, it's the same thing of it just looks super cheap actually on your body. The seams are falling apart. I was able to find a couple of the bathing suits that I got on AliExpress. I wasn't able to find this one. It's kind of hard to narrow down the search for floral swimsuits. I was able to find this one. I was able to find this one. I was able to find another one that I got rid of because it just looked really stupid on me. I don't know why I thought that would look good on me. Wishful thinking, maybe? I don't know. None of the photos that I found on AliExpress for these were the same photos that were on this swimwear company's website. They clearly had like two or three models that they used. They were all clearly fresh photos of the swimsuits and these models in the swimsuits. But maybe this will work for you. Check their photos. Do a reverse image search. They did end up ripping off photos for other things that wasn't swimwear, but I'll get there. I think at the time I was still holding out hope of being put on their Instagram. A different friend of mine who does a lot of my photos, we planned a day to go to a different beach. It was overcast, it was busy, so we couldn't really get a lot of good variety in shots. And also, again, I was real sick at the time. These photos weren't taken far apart from each other, but I do look quite different in both of them, and a lot of it has to do with angles. And at the end of the day, these are taken by two different people. Both of them are great. Hi Kat, hi Hannah, thank you for putting up with me and my insecurities. But these ones, we were trying to achieve a very specific look. We had basically stalked this brand's Instagram and figured out what they wanted. They never posted full body photos of girls in their bathing suits. They typically would post more close-up shots of their ambassadors and also waist-up shots. So that's what we tried to get a lot of, which didn't do me a lot of favors, but that's on me. All of these are still up on my Instagram. I did scrub the brand's name from my Instagram, so you will not find them, hopefully. Originally, I did tag the company and I used the hashtags and I tagged ambassador and I did all that. The brand liked one of the photos, nothing else. Long story short, I didn't end up on their Instagram. It was a big old waste of time and money. I did leave the photos up because I do like some of them. And content. When I posted these photos, I started being reached out to by more brands. Some of them were just commenting like, oh, looking cute, like things like that on the photos. But most of them were like, hey, check your DMs. And they were also offering me ambassadorships. I responded with this very long-winded thing saying like, hey, I'm an ambassador for this brand currently, and I don't have a lot of money, so I can't afford to buy your too. Another company reached out to me later than the other ones did, and they said they wanted to talk about a sponsorship opportunity, and I was like, okay, cool, this is different. Sponsorship and ambassador are not the same thing. They sent me the link, and it was an ambassador program. They just called it a sponsorship in the DM, and I was like, hey, that's not the same thing. And they're like, oh, it's only if you have 10K at least. I think I said something like super sarcastic, like maybe don't call it a sponsorship, have a lovely day. So being a part of that ambassadorship did get me exposure with brands. However, it gave me the wrong type of exposure with brands, because it gave me exposure with brands who were like, great, we know she's stupid enough to fall for the ambassadorship ploy. Great, love it, let's see if she'll do it again. Now, I'm not saying that all the companies that reached out to me were also dropshipping sites or anything like that, but they were offering very similar deals to the one that I had been dealing with, so I dropped it. I did leave the discount code in the description box for the photos for a couple months, and then I took it off, and then recently, before this video, I took off all the tags for the company, so hopefully there's no way to find this company through my Instagram. I still get the emails from the company. They've had a couple trip giveaways in the past year, but I've never seen any photos come out of them, and so I don't think they exist. But if I did win one, it sounds like a great way to be abducted. This past January, they announced they were going to be releasing a winter sweater collection for their swimsuit brand. Great, keep it going year round, whatever. If you were an ambassador, you got early access. By the way, they sold out before they even launched the product. This time I was smart enough to do a reverse image search, and I found that all of the photos for their new line were stolen, and then they just like changed the colors on a couple of them. Nothing that I experienced was the end of the world. Do I still have two of are the swimsuits that I probably can't wear out in public? Yes. Did I lose some money? Yes. But it's not like I dished out hundreds or thousands of dollars thinking that this was gonna launch me into influencerdom or anything like that. I had mostly reasonable expectations going into this, and then it just didn't work out for me because I did it poorly or it was just stupid. I don't know. What probably happened is that I was wrong in the beginning and that the people that they were promoting on their Instagram already had a couple thousand followers. I had 500. Maybe I didn't stand a chance from the get-go. It didn't matter how the photos turned out. Maybe I was just destined to lose money the entire time. My analytics tell me that most of my demographic are young women around my same age group and then a little older. So predominantly, you and I are the targets of influencer marketing. But we are also the targets of predatory marketing tactics such as the ambassador marketing tactic, because a lot of people that want to follow influencers also kind of think, I could do that. I could be an influencer. How great would that be to be an influencer? And a lot of these brands see that and they want to take advantage of that. So that's predominantly why I wanted to make this video. If there's anything you take away from this video or my channel in general, it's one, learn from my mistakes, but also just question things, you know? If it sounds too good, question it. Even if it doesn't sound too good and you're like, I don't know, ask a couple more questions, because that's typically when arguments start falling apart. Don't be a sheep. Don't blindly follow things. Don't blindly follow people. Don't blindly follow me. Question things. That's it. Have you been a part of a brand ambassadorship? Let me know. Does the brand that I told you about sound familiar? Were you one of their ambassadors? Did you fall for the same bullshit that I did? Let me know. Maybe we can swap discount codes. Thank you to Catherine, Sarah, and Aaron for supporting me on my Patreon. If you would also like to support me on Patreon and support this channel, the link will be listed down below. Follow me on all my social media, including my Instagram. I don't often post bikini photos, but they're still up there. That'll be all up here. That's pretty much it. Like, comment, subscribe, and all that good stuff. Thank you for watching. After watching this video, you may think that I'm stupid for having fallen for this, but trust me, I think worse of myself.